Shannon Sharp, who is legend of a football player, have no idea how he was a seventh round draft pick just at the end of the day. Hall of Fame, stud, him and Skip go after it every single morning, okay? Mm-hmm. And that is amazing. This morning, Shannon Sharp, I don't know if he called or somebody, who did he call?
Yeah,
I think so.
He called.
He calls Julio Jones, who was seen in a Cowboys jersey this week, or a Cowboys hoodie this weekend. He calls Julio Jones on the spot to ask him, hey, what's going on? Because I assume Skip is getting very excited about him potentially being a Cowboy and right. All this. Julio Jones answers, and we get some information out of the Atlanta Falcons Julio Jones situation that is just live on the air and absolutely incredible reporting by Shannon Sharp. Did Julio know he was being recorded or he was live? We have no idea, but I do know this came out of that conversation this morning.
Uncle, what's going on, bro?
Man, nothing much. About to go meet up with my brother. What's happening with you?
Man, look, you want to go to the Cowboys, Julio, or you want to stay in Atlanta?
Oh, man, I'm out of there, man.
He's out of there.
Oh, are you going to? Ideally, where would you like to go?
Right now, I want to win.
Okay. Dallas. Well, don't go to Dallas. If you go, you ain't winning in Dallas, Julio.
Well, then after that, actually, he laughs and says, oh, I already know. So, yeah. So there was like quite a shot, that whole thing. But him saying, I'm out of there, is that the first time? I mean, Atlanta has come out. It's been, you know, kind of, I guess, reported a couple of – they were asking for a one going into the draft. That's allegedly out there. Now they're definitely looking to shop him. Now you're Julio, like, I'm out of there. So I don't know what Chris Ballard is doing. But what Chris Ballard needs to do is get in on the game. Mm. And by the way, I'm sure I'm not the only fan of a team that's thinking this exact thing. At Boston Connor was thinking this morning with the New England Patriots. Get them up there, especially with the whole offensive revamp that they have. Packers, even though your quarterback's singing a little karaoke in Hawaii, you get Julio
Jones.
That's
how you bring him home.
You get him two. Uh-huh. You get him two fucking guitars if you want to. People are saying the Niners. Obviously, there's a lot of teams that would want Julio Jones. I think this could become a little bit of a maybe a little bit of a who can out-offer who.
Yeah.
With Shannon Sharp on the phone on Undisputed Live, Julio Jones says, I'm out of there. I just want to go to a winner as well. So now this is obviously throwing a little bit of gasoline into the fire that Julio is going to be on the move. Where's he going to go? Previously to the draft, allegedly it is being reported that they wanted a one overall for Julio Jones. I, in my eyes, would have given that up immediately for Julio Jones. And a lot of people are saying a 34-year-old, old wide receiver is not worth a one. It's like, if he comes on your team and you win a Super Bowl next year, who gives a damn about that one?
Yeah.
It's about winning Super Bowls, is it not? There's a lot of teams, I think, that if you add Julio to them, immediately Super Bowl conversation participants.
Yeah.
Honestly believe that. Now, there's obviously Kansas City and Tampa Bay, and there's other teams that we're always going to consider to be up in the upper echelon. Green Bay Packers with Aaron Rodgers, who is currently singing in Hawaii. Mm-hmm. But there's teams that we have in that upper echelon. But there's a lot of teams, like the Titans, for instance. Titans are just, what, 1 year removed from losing to the Kansas City Chiefs in the playoffs after having quite a substantial lead in them. Then they lose to the Baltimore Ravens in playoffs this year. But if the Tennessee Titans add Julio Jones to that offense, is that not immediately make them a much better team in the AFC, in which they are already a great team? The Colts, although we have no idea what Carson Wentz is going to be able to do, okay? Carson Wentz could be, completely broken. Frank Reich doesn't like hearing that. Okay, Frank Reich says, I kind of cringe whenever I hear people say Carson could be broken, because Carson still has the ability to be great. He loves Frank Reich. It looks like he's enjoying the hell out of his time with the Indianapolis Colts thus far. Balls are flying out of his hand beautifully. Jonathan Taylor's catching go routes. I mean, there is a chance that Carson Wentz and the Colts are unbelievable. He could stink, though.
Yeah,
that could
absolutely
happen. Mm-hmm. I have no idea. I don't think it's going to happen with the offensive line and Frank Reich seeming to bring him out of his shell a little bit and back into what he was when he was an MVP-like player. But he could stink. But let's say he doesn't stink. Let's say he's good. You bring Julio to this Colts team, I think everybody in Indianapolis is like, okay, now we got a guy.
Yeah.
Now we got, not that we don't have T.Y., absolute stud. T.Y. on his Twitter, by the way, last week, who's the best receiver in the NFL outside the Colts? Julio, he said. Mm-hmm. You bring Julio to that team, it opens up a lot for T.Y. because they can't just triple team him on the defensive side, which, by the way, might also help Michael Pittman.
Oh,
hey, rookie last year, 13 yards and a touchdown in his debut season, number 11 for the Indianapolis Colts. I don't know how Julio's going to do with that. Carson Wentz had to bow down to Michael Pittman, who, you know, obviously has a huge upside after that. Last year, he had 12 yards and a touchdown. Yep. He could potentially come into his own this year, and number 11 is his cemented. Paris Campbell also, potential injury problems could come, but also he could be electrifying. You add Julio there. I'm thinking with that defense, okay, we're in the AFC Championship game at least. Mm-hmm. Titans fans are thinking that. Packers fans like, we have Julio. Okay, we're probably getting to the Super Bowl unlike last year. Yeah. There's a 49ers probably thinking that. The Patriots, although they have spent $157 million on one day in guaranteed contracts, first day of tampering period, they had Julio there. It's like Cam Newton allegedly looks a lot better at throwing the ball than he did last year.
Allegedly.
There's a tweet coming out that he worked on some of his mechanics that he might have forgotten or kind of fell out of after this past offseason where he was released and was working out. His mechanics might not have been as great last season. This offseason, he worked back on the fundamentals, and his teammates are saying it's showing off, or it's proven itself, and it's working, and he's throwing the ball much better. He would have to, obviously, because he had 8 touchdowns last year. Okay, that's not great for any NFL quarterback, but he also did have COVID, and he had no weapons. Now, they have a plethora of weapons, a tight end that's going down to tight end university in Hunter Henry. Mm-hmm. I think Yanu Smith is also going. Yep. If they bring in Julio and Cam and everything like that, they're going to succeed. But let's say Cam can't. Let's say Cam can't do it. I think he will be able to, but let's say he can't. Mac Jones can throw the ball all over the yard if he can be protected. That is what everybody has said about him. You get Julio on that team, two dominant tight ends, great running backs, and another. I mean, there is a chance that the Patriots all the way back in the conversation. Absolutely. And they have, I think, the ammo to make the move, both in draft capital. I think they have cap space still somehow. Oh, yeah. I think they could make the move, but the Patriots all the way back in there. I think this is a pivotal moment for who's going to make a real run next year with who Julio goes to. Because it's not just adding Julio's production. It's opening up the rest of the defense when you get a Julio on your team. And I think if he lands in a lot of places, it's going to be a devastating blow for the rest of their division. And the Atlanta Falcons said they would prefer not to trade him to an NFC team. But if it's right, they will do it.
Yeah, and it feels like one of those things like last year with, you know, Brady, where it's like, hey, why aren't there 32 teams going after Julio right now? Because what you just said, he makes your wide receivers, your tight ends, your running backs, your quarterbacks exponentially better.
Okay, so let's go back to the beginning when Julio – the Falcons traded up to get Julio in the draft to number 6 overall. PFF just tweeted out what it has been. It's been nearly 10 years since the Falcons traded up to number 6 to get Julio Jones. What did they give to the Cleveland Browns? They gave a first rounder, a second rounder, and a fourth rounder in 2011, and a first rounder and a fourth rounder in the next year. Okay, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 picks for Julio Jones. I would assume all the geniuses... all the geniuses. Oh, they overpaid. They overpaid. Well, you can't give up that much draft capital and be good. You can't do it. The Browns fleeced the Falcons in this trade. I assume that is what was said by these people who are experts on the thing. This is who they got for that. D-tackle Phil Taylor, wide receiver Greg Little, fullback Owen Maricich, and Brandon Weeden at quarterback. So I don't know what happened to the other pick. They must have traded it away. I will take the, hey, give me the guarantee of who's going to be what over the possibility of what the future can hold. That's it. It's going to come out what the Falcons trade Julio for. And it's going to happen after June 1 because the contract is basically set up for that. It'll be a lot more money saved for the Falcons if they trade him after June 1. But they could trade him today and it'd be designated post June 1. These are all semantics, basically. But if, when it comes out what he was traded for, I think there's going to be 31 fan bases that are going to be pissed off about it.
Oh, yeah.
Well, and everyone talks about like how no one wants to give away a one. And the longer we are removed from the draft and like his, you know, I mean, if he's going for a second and a third, it just it makes no sense that you would. Even if he is a little banged up or whatever, like he definitely still has good football in him. I mean, he's a freak. So like if he is healthy or at least healthy enough to give you, you know. I mean,
he's 12 Julio games. Jones.
Yeah, exactly. Like, there's no reason you don't go after him.
And was Julio injured last year?
Yeah, a little bit.
He missed games. 7 games.
Yeah. But he closed, right? Didn't he end the season?
Yeah.
He ended the season. Him and Matt Ryan were playing their best football. I thought it was potentially an audition to get them out of there. Matt Ryan's contract is basically saying that Arthur Smith has to keep him around. Not that I don't think they would have been able to trade him, by the way. $100 million, I think, in guarantees. Everybody's like, if they wanted to move on for Matt, they could. I don't know if that's accurate.
Impossible.
I'm not, especially with the way salaries are and contracts with this cap and everything. And by the way, Matt, I was told by a source that whenever I say that Matt Ryan doesn't have it anymore, I'm an idiot. Okay? And I've never said Matt Ryan doesn't have it anymore. I'm just saying, is Matt Ryan the guy who's going to win you a Super Bowl? I've been told that there's a couple passes in the old route tree that he's the best in the NFL at throwing. Now, is he the best in the NFL at throwing certain routes, like seven, because Julio Jones is there? Potentially. That's that catch on the sideline that you remember from the Super Bowl. Maybe he is the best at that. I think Herbert throws that ball well as well. But whenever you talk about a quarterback with Julio Jones, I think you're setting them up for massive amounts of success. Matt Ryan has come out and said, I have no idea what it would be like without Julio Jones.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, like, they're still talented for sure. They got Pitts. They have a couple of those other guys. But, like, I mean, we will noticeably see a difference in their offense if Julio's not there.
Think about Kyle Pitts, Ridley, and also Julio Jones potentially on the same offense. That seems like one that you would want to have.
Yeah.
So I don't know why they're so gung-ho on trading him. I guess it's because the contract, and they can't get rid of Matt Ryan for the contract he has. But for me, it's just like, Julio Jones, dude.
Yeah. When